She lived her faith in her very unselfish actions. I will say what drives me is because it does have my mother's name on it. Ruth was a wonderful person. She loved people. She loved getting to know people. She was a child of the Depression, so she also really loved a good bargain. She's been gone for 12 years. My mother was the most loving person I've ever known in my life, and she never met a stranger. She loved to get to know people. And so when she died, and I was pretty depressed and feeling really low and like, is this all there is? And feeling really very faithless. One day, I heard these words kind of drop in my head that said, do something in her name. And having been involved in Habitat, being one of the founding board members, I thought, let's open a thrift store.
When we opened on Locust Street, it was an extremely small building. And as we were clearing it out and building shelves and moving shelves in, we looked around and we saw this place and thought, that's a lot of space to put some stuff. I wonder if we're going to get enough. And we really, really worried about whether or not we were going to get enough things to sell and get enough people in to donate and then to buy. And so we did that with great trepidation, but we had more things than we could deal with. And it was a blessing. Absolute blessing.
I'll never forget that I walked in about, I think we opened on December 16th, 2000. And I walked in about 2 days before, and the little shop we occupied at that time was adorable. But all the objects were out, and not a single one had a price on
it. No, that's right. It didn't.
And I said, Bunny, I'm a let's get the job done. I said, Bunny, I think we need to get on with it. But we got open, and how long? We only stayed there about 3 years before we ran out of room, didn't we?
Oh, a little longer than that.
Was it?
Yeah, I think so. We were longer than that. And then I guess my greatest memory of that old place is when it rained, we'd stand there and watch the creek rise.
Right, because our building was right over the creek. Oh, that was something.
Yeah.
Well, of course, our main aim is to help with Habitat for Humanity. So I see us building, enabling other people to build. It's like in my case, I can't climb a ladder, but I can sure polish up a pair of old earrings and bag them and price them. And finding a spot that, you know, something that each of us finds something we can do. The main thing is turning trash into treasure. And I think I'm good at that because I'm a child of the Depression. I remember the Great Depression very well. And my mother was a wizard at turning nothing into something. She just was amazing at that. And so that's the way I was brought up. But my feeling is every quarter we get in represents a handful of nails that will help build a house for Habitat.
The relationships that we develop and support is the single most important element to being a fulfilled person. You need to have a sense of contribution, a sense of purpose, and those of us here have that sense of purpose and contribution, and we have one another.
Oh, there's no words to express how I feel about Bunny. That she's one of the main reasons people keep coming back is because of Bunny. There's just a light that Bunny has that surrounds us all, and it makes us all feel better. It certainly does me. You know, if you feel bad, I just come up here, and then I feel fine. And it's just hard to explain, but I think one of the reasons everybody comes back is because of Bunny. The people are great. The customers are great. What we do is great. Habitat is a wonderful organization. It makes me very proud to be part of something that has given over $1 million to such a good cause. There's just so many things that's so special about this place. I mean, unlike any other resale shop I've ever been in, and I've been in every one of them, I can assure you. And they all do good work, the nonprofits, they all support great organizations, but it's Bunny, you know? That's what it is, it's Bunny. There's just nobody like Bunny.